Hello everyone, welcome to this channel and this channel is my channel and I am Kirti. It feels really weird to say your name. Hello everyone, welcome to this channel and today I am going to tell you about how I lost 15 kgs in 15 days. No, I'm kidding. How I lost 15 kgs in a month. And to everybody's disappointment, this video actually is how I lost 15 kgs in 1 year.
Wait a minute.
Because I think that is sustainable, that is doable, and that is you can keep it off for the rest of your life. So first of all, why am I making this video? Because I used to be really sad and then I lost all the weight and I became amazing and happy. So I want to share all of this happiness to all of the lovely people out there and I want them also to be really, really, really happy just like me. Nothing sort of like this, because recently I've noticed that these are kind of videos that I have lost this much of weight, I have lost that much of weight, I have lost this, I have lost that, I have lost everything, has a lot of views and it makes a lot of views. So just for the views, simply for the views, I'm making this video. But whatever I'm going to be sharing here is completely just my experience, my understanding and whatever I have learned through the process. So finally, let's move to the January 2020. So what I did in January 2020 to lose my weight. So the first thing was to make myself educated. Yes, that is the most important thing before you start anything, to get some knowledge that how the things work. So the first thing that I understood was the maths and the thermodynamics behind losing, gaining weight. So why I said thermodynamics? Because according to first law of thermodynamics, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only transfer one medium to another. So whatever we are eating and then putting ourselves in terms of the energy is the energy intake, and then whatever we are burning and the body is doing some work, and in terms of that we are having the energy out from our body. So we are going to summarize it as calorie in, calorie out. So the calorie in is from our consumption, solely from our consumption, whatever we are eating which has calories. There are foods also which doesn't have calories, like water, coffee. There are a lot of calorie less food also. Okay, and then rest of the foods, whatever we eat, it possesses some calories. And then whatever the activities we do or our body does, it burns those calories. So it has to be, if you want to lose weight, your calorie in should be less than your calories out, so that whatever calorie deficit you will be having, you will be losing weight according to that. If you want to gain the weight, then your calories out should be less than your calories in. So when, and if you have calorie surplus, according to that calorie surplus, you're going to gain the weight. So now, how many calories surplus or calorie deficit you require to lose 1 kg of weight or 1 pound of weight? So per pound of weight, you need to have a 3500 calorie deficit. So for I think 1 kg, it will be around 7500 to 8000. Yeah, let's move to the next part. I told you about the calories intake. The intake is just with the food, and then when you burn, you burn your food in 4 different parts, which is called your total daily energy expenditure. So what is your energy expenditure in the entire day? It usually divides in the 4 parts. So the first part of it, TDEE, is the BMR, your basal metabolic rate. So basal metabolic rate exactly is the amount of calories your body itself burns when you're not doing anything. If you're lying on a bed, just breathing the entire day, this much amount of calories, like 70-80% of the calories, total expenditure is done by the BMR. So the BMR is affected by a lot of things. So it affects by whether you're male or female, different compositions of body, your genetics and your weight, your height. So now comes to the second part, which is the physical activities, the exercises, and then the conscious effort you put to burn those calories. It could be running, walking, and then any sort of swimming, any sort of physical activities you do. Like, you get my point, right? So now comes to the third part, which I have put third according to the preference, which is a non-exercise activity thermogenesis, which is also called NEAT, which is the amount of calories you're burning from your physical activities, which is not exercise. You're standing while cooking, you're talking on a phone and roaming here and there, any sort of physical activity which you do not consider as an exercise, because they also burn a lot of calories and you don't realize it. So now comes the final part, which is the thermic effect of food. So whatever food you're consuming, your body takes up energy to burn that food or to digest that food also. So it can also differ from the amount of food you are eating. If you are eating more food, then your thermogenesis of food will increase. That doesn't make sense. Like, you're gonna eat a lot of food, okay, so my body will burn more calories. No, you are putting that amount of food also inside you, so that doesn't make any sense, of course. But why I said it differs also, because if you're eating very simple plain processed food and simple carbs, your body doesn't take a lot of energy to burn that food. If you're eating complex carbs, or if you're eating protein, your body takes a lot of energy to burn that. There's not that much difference in that. It's very little different, but still there is a difference. So now I think it has given you the idea of the calories in, calories out, or the energy in or the energy out. So this is the only system and functioning which works in terms of losing weight or the gaining weight. You can do whatever you want, but this is the actual science and maths and whatever is behind that, according to me. Yeah, bigger disclaimer, according to me, according to my knowledge, according to my little brain inside this head. So now move to the second part, which is the most tedious part, and nobody's going to like that. But whatever the knowledge that we have gained in the first part, I'm going to put that, all of that, into the practical work. So I'm not going to do everything in the pen and paper. So I've downloaded an app called Yazio, and through that app, I have accounted everything on that. So first thing that I had to do, I had to calculate my TDEE. So I didn't end up calculating my entire TDEE. You can calculate it if you want. There's so many online calculators, but I didn't end up doing that. So I only calculated my BMR. So for BMR also, I'm not sure that is your actual BMR, but it will give you the idea, because nothing in this thing, what you're doing exactly, is giving you the exact number. That's for sure, because you're gonna make mistakes in the calculation. You're gonna make mistake in assuming or calculating your BMR also, because BMR you cannot calculate just with your height, weight, and whether you're male or female. There's a lot of factors which affect BMR also. But why am I saying this? You'll never end up getting the exact number, but will be around that number. So according to my BMR, in the app, I can add also my exercise, what exercise I was doing, and I have also linked that app to the Apple Health. So if I'm taking steps, like I have taken some 5,000 steps one day, so it will reduce those amount of kilocalories burned. So that app's function usually works like that. You have the number of calories you can consume, and the amount of the calories in lunch, breakfast, snack, and dinner you are going to consume, it deducts those calories. So by the time, like, you, for me, the target, if it's 1500 and the amount of exercise or the walking, whatever I'm doing, it adds up those calories also. Like, be 1500 is my BMR, then the other things it adds up, maybe it makes it to 1800 or 1900 calories, whatever, for the day. So, and then I can consume all of that thing. And if I have consumed under that, because I have set my goal is to lose the weight. So according to my goal, if I'm under that calories, it shows a green for that day. Otherwise, if I exceed that calorie, it shows a red. So in the beginning, I was really motivated. So in the app, you can see in the beginning of the months, I had more greens. But later when I moved into that, I have more reds. And during the holiday season, during the summers and during the Christmas, it's too much of red. And by the end of this Christmas, or by the end of this year, I have stopped doing it, which I'll tell you later on why. So I did that. So yeah, I have calculated everything, and I know also that this is not easy, but after a point of time, you get accustomed to it. So let's move to the third part. From accounting my calories and everything, I got to learn a lot about food. First, the basic categorization of macronutrients, carbohydrate, fats, protein, fiber, and then a lot about micronutrients also. So when I started in the beginning, because of accounting things, I knew I had to eat more protein, because protein, our body digest protein and breaks down it very slowly, just like complex carbs also. And then protein is also more satiating. So in the beginning of accounting, what mistake I did is, so in each gram of food, in each gram of protein, and in each gram of carb, there is 4 kilocalories, but in 1 gram of fat, there is 9 kilocalories. So I cut down to my fat very minimum, like very bare minimum, because I knew it's just double the calories. Why do I want to waste my calories to put some extra oil or something? So I started focusing more on the carbs and protein, and more so because of protein, because I used to think like I'll be feeling more full after that. So it's good for the weight loss because it's normal basic calculation, but for health there are a lot more things than just calories in, calories out, because in fats also there are saturated fats, there's trans, there is polysaturated, there's unsaturated, there's a lot of varieties of the fats, and not all fats are bad, because the fats which come from avocado is really good, it's a good fat, and then from seeds, from nuts, there's a lot of good fats also. I started cutting down them also. I didn't want to eat almonds, all of the nut fruits, seeds also, but then I understood if I want to have fats, I have good ones which are tasty also, which I like also, and which are healthy also. So all of these food groups are really important. So all of the understanding of these food groups is also very important, because when you're plating your everyday food, each meal, it should be balanced, well balanced, with healthy fats, carbohydrates, proteins, and some vegetables also, some fruits. A lot of variation should be there so that you're getting all of the micronutrients also, because you cannot account all of your micronutrients. It's not possible. So that will be another classification. So this was the third point, which is very important to understand, not in the journey of losing weight or gaining weight, but in the normal day of eating also, you should have a balance of all the foods and enjoy all of those balanced foods. So to summarize everything, three things you have to do to lose the weight. First thing, you have to understand about TDEE, calories in, calories out, energy in, energy out, whatever you want to say. The second thing is you have to keep everything accounted. If you don't want to keep everything accounted, be mindful about it, learn about everything. And the third one is the food groups. Eat more balanced food, learn about the food, what you're eating, make it more balanced, moderately eat everything possible. Eat something for your body, eat something for your soul. Yes, I eat donuts for my soul. So these were the major three things that I have focused on. So in the entire journey of 1 year, I have never been very regular, never. It was never like a continuous work, or the motivation was never up to the mark to do it regularly. If somebody has it, it's good for them, but I don't have that much. I love food also. I want to eat everything. I want to enjoy my holidays. I want to enjoy everything. When I go home 1 month, I want to have every other Indian food and street food. So I didn't have that much of will, but still it's possible. So yeah, and finally by the end of January, my weight was 60, from 74 to 60. And then from January till April, it's constant. And why I made this video right now is that because I could have made the video where I lost 4-5 kgs also, because I was not sure the entire year, am I keeping this weight off? Like, I have lost 15 kgs, but can I keep it off? But now after 4-5 months being constantly hovering around the same weight and enjoying my life, enjoying what I eat and not suffering in any shape or form, I love what I eat. I can eat whenever, wherever, whatever I want to eat. I'm confident enough now that yes, I can keep this weight off. And the best part of it, I used to use that app and account my food till December 15 around. I have not used the app since then, and still I'm eating what I want to eat and I'm at the same weight. So that's a success. I'm not telling you to wait, to account, and to do everything for the rest of your life. That's not possible. That's not good also. How can you enjoy your life if you can account everything? This is so much of calculative life. Nobody can live like this. And this is my experience that I'm telling you. In no shape or form I'm saying that you can only lose weight if you're going to follow this. You can do whatever you want to and still lose weight. But this is what I'm saying, how I lost weight, and I still feel happy about it. And I have stopped doing all of those things, but because of that knowledge which I gathered in 1 year, I can now, without thinking, can have everything, because I know what goes in what things, and my body knows now what I feel after eating what thing. So yeah, that is it for the video. And if you have any question regarding whatever I have said in the video, do let me know in the comment down below. And if you have any other idea about any other video, please, please, please do let me know in the comment down below also. And thank you so, so, so much for watching. And yes, please like, share, and subscribe. Bye-bye. now just I have to think about the some good and cool thumbnail. Here I'm gonna put something like me in white clothes, because in white you look even more fat. And here I'm going to capture some like thin version of me in black clothes. In black you look even thin. But black is my favorite color also. Is it because of that? No, I love black. Black, 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 black.